What's up, everybody? Welcome back to another video from the Self-Built Campervan channel. It's Monday, the 12th of March 2018, and this is part two from my Scotland trip, covering the North Coast 500 and the Isle of Skye. Spent the third night at Duncansby Head Lighthouse, which was last night. It's day four today. I'll just get out the van and just show you where I parked up to last night. Spectacular view of the Orkneys and Stormer Island. Alright guys, it's 10:40 and just leaving the lighthouse now. I've tapped Drunna Groats in the sat nav. It's 1.6 miles away, 5-minute drive. Just going to take a look at Drunna Groats. Not going to stay too long as I visited it back last August, but I'm just going to have a quick walk around, just a few photos. And today I will be travelling across the North Coast, and I'll be looking for somewhere to park up, somewhere around Armidale. On a 11:45 and back on the roads now, travelling along the A836 westbound. Spent a little bit of time at Drunna Groats, wandering around and taking photos this morning, but I've put Durness in the sat nav. It's 92 miles and it's going to take about 2 hours 45 minutes. To stop off at Armidale and a couple of other places along the route. Somewhere around 1 o'clock-ish, I'll be pulling over for lunch. But the weather's changed again, and a little bit of rain in the air. Let's hope it holds off. Thank you. it's just coming up to 1:45 and pulled over for a spot of lunch. But pulled into a viewpoint. I'll just get out the van and spin the camera around, show you the view I've got from where I've parked to. There's a couple of ham and Red Leicester cheese sandwiches made up, and a cup of coffee to wash it down with. It's just coming up to 2:50. I've had my dinner. It makes a change having cheese and ham sandwiches instead of having bacon and egg, or even sausage and fried onion. So just passing Armadale at the moment. Gotta stop off at a shop at some point to pick up some supplies. But hour and a half away from Durness, 46 miles. Well, it's just coming up to 20 past 5 and just pulled up at Durness Beach. I'm not going to be staying here tonight as the car park's a bit of a slope, but going to be looking for somewhere to park up for the night now. Whether I can get up on top of one of the hills over to my right hand side, or there's a beach 1.5 miles away over on the west coast. Gonna check that out, but got phone reception, got 3G at the moment, but hopefully I can find somewhere with a little bit of internet. But gonna go for a quick drive and see what I can find. The time's coming on 6:10, and managed to find a spot to park up for the night, just outside of Durness. But this is the view that I have looking out of my my sliding door. Well, I've put the kettle on, made myself a cup of tea, and just reheating last night's lamb stew for dinner this evening. After dinner, I'm going to sit back and relax, watch a few videos on YouTube, and probably stick the TV on and watch a little bit of TV this evening. It's just coming up to 9 o'clock, and just been relaxing this evening, watching videos on YouTube and doing a little bit of research. But last night, spent the night at Duncansby Head Lighthouse, which is in the far northeast. After breakfast, I went across to John O'Groats, took some photos, which is just there. I then followed the coast roads along the north coast. There's Amberdale. Carried on all the way along this road, headed for Durness, which is just here. This evening I'm parked up somewhere around this point, cracking view out to out to sea and a beach down below. But after breakfast tomorrow, I'll be heading into Durness, have a look around, take some photos. And then I'm going to follow this road, coming all the way down. Be looking somewhere nice to park up for lunch. But I'll be heading for Earl Pool, which is just here. But tomorrow evening, I'll be looking to park up somewhere around at this point, along this road, up to somewhere around this point, which should be my last night on the north coast. The following day I'll be heading to Applecross. I'll be doing the Applecross Pass and then going across onto the Isle of Skye, where I'll be spending 4 nights on the Isle of Skye. And then my last night will be somewhere around Loch Lomond. But that's it for part two, so stay tuned for part three. Thanks for watching the video. Don't forget to give us a thumbs up, share the video, and if you're not already subscribed to the channel, hit that subscribe button. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.